o'clock. Okay, let's move.
Our chairman is up at the Board of Selectmen tonight, so as vice chair, I'll be starting the meeting until he gets back. Please note that this meeting is being made available to the public through an audio recording, which will be used to ensure an accurate record of proceedings produced in the minutes of the meeting. All comments made in open session will be recorded. Tonight is Monday, July 25th, 2016. This is the continued public hearing for plan number 1601 entitled Bryson Way Extension and Adam Square Condos for Monday, July 11th, 2016 at 7:30 p.m.
Did I put 7:30 at 7:04?
No, it says continued from Monday at 7, July 11th at
7:30. Oh, no, oh, it's tonight, it's at 7 o'clock.
It's on the online agenda.
Yeah.
No, but on July 11th it was at 7:30 apparently.
Yes, that was 7:30. Did I put 7 o'clock for tonight?
Yeah. You didn't put anything for tonight.
Oh.
It's on the agenda, posted.
Yeah, it is. It always is on the website.
And I think we had also told everyone at the last meeting that it would be at 7 o'clock tonight. We also have on the agenda that we need to consider or vote on conditions to be written for the plan for... The subdivision plan for Bryson Way Extension. The subdivision plan. Let me just see something. Marilyn, is this right? You have the continued public hearing for plan number 1601 entitled Bryson Way Extension and Adam Square Condos?
Yes, because they were together. They were grouped together.
Because at the last meeting we approved the subdivision plan.
Yes, we did, but we never continued. We got a 90-day extension that we got to vote on, okay? And now we have to, tonight we have to set up a date certain for the next continued hearing for Adam Square.
For the site plan for Adam Square?
Yes.
Okay.
Because last week it was, 2 weeks ago it was,
we had our conditions.
And we never closed the public hearing for Bryson Way.
So we were just opening the meeting and opening the hearing, so here we go.
I'll get the air conditioning.
And we're recording, so we're good to go. No, seriously, go ahead.
All set?
Yeah, we're all set. We're open.
So on the subdivision, just conditions, Mr. Taylor sent over a request summarizing the waivers that were being asked for. And hopefully you've had a chance to take a look at them. I don't think there's anything too complicated. We had Mr. Palmieri's letter last week, and this is a letter in response. Relative to the site plan that you've been asked to approve, just so the board is aware, on July 13th we did apply for the variance with the Zoning Board of Appeals. I can give you a copy of the application if you needed it. But it is from that Article 3, Section 9, non-residential frontage provision. So to the extent that the Board of Appeals believes that we need that variance, we've asked for that, and we'll make that case to them. It's not scheduled for tonight's hearing. Michelle Dowling told me that it will be scheduled, but it hasn't been scheduled yet. Their board is in flux, I guess, with their membership, so I think that has to be settled first. We do have, later on tonight, the special permit hearing with them, and that will likely go forward. It looks like they have a quorum over there. So, but we are going to ask them to approve the plan subject to a decision on the variance, and I'm hoping that you would do the same. This is a variance that I did have applied for in the past. I think if you look back at the history of the bylaws, and Mr. DiMarzo had them outside, this non-residential frontage provision went into the bylaws about 1980. This was before the use multi-family or multi-family dwellings were inserted into the bylaw. So it was impossible for them to have envisioned that that would be a use that wouldn't have the benefit of this type of thing. you know, this is a residential use. We believe that it was always intended to prevent commercial and industrial uses accessing a lot of streets other than the ones that were set forth in the bylaw as a measure of kind of curtailing the spread of commercial industrial uses throughout the town, which seems to make a lot of sense. It just doesn't seem to make a lot of sense when you have residential use like this, which isn't even a high-density development, not being able to create new subdivision access where it's appropriate. So we've asked for that variance. I will leave you with the arguments that I've made, that I would making to the Zoning Board of Appeals, if that's of any interest to you. But I guess my request would be that you consider approving it, subject to the Zoning Board's final decision on that. So the findings that you have to basically make were that there was an appropriate density to the development, which is less than 4 units per acre. That's what the bylaw requires. Clearly that's the case. You have to make a finding that the proposed use is not injurious, noxious, offensive, or detrimental to the neighborhood. You know, there's a de minimis traffic impact. I would say not even appreciable. It's less than a 1 second delay at Old Washington and Washington. I think we're going to be able to satisfy the abutter who's on the opposite side of the street, but regardless of whether this project or a straight residential subdivision, cars are going to come in and out of Bryson Way or Bryson Way Extension, and they're going to cause the same concerns that we're going to try to mitigate for that gentleman. There's adequate on-site waste disposal and suitable soils for on-lot sewerage. There's adequate town water available. The requested use is not overly dense and does meet the requirements of the bylaw. The residents are typically empty nesters. These are two-bedroom units. They don't generate a significant amount of traffic, as I've said. There's no nuisance or serious hazard to pedestrians or vehicles. As a matter of fact, we're probably creating safer access to the rear and on a street that looks appropriately designed and I think is met with the approval of the peer reviewer. So as a condition of approval, I would ask that you, if you feel it's necessary, just allow us to continue to work with the abutter on the opposite side to screen any lights, and then accept the condition that, if required, we'd obtain the variance to allow the proposed multi-unit dwellings to have access off of Bryson Way Extension.
Well, just as an addition to that, I'm not sure if everyone, you know, heard this at the end of the last meeting, but we did have a discussion with the abutter across the street and agreed that we'd work with him directly on either fencing, shrubs, windows that might be non-glare windows. There were a few different options that him and his wife were discussing, and we agreed, you know, we don't have a preference. We want to see it solved, so we were waiting for him to come back, but that we'd, you know, we'd work with them on that.
And it does seem like there's a great deal of anxiety on the street regarding traffic, but I would suggest that it's probably not because of this development. It's because of the existing conditions out there now that we're not a significant contributor to. So I'll leave it at that.
Excuse me, Emma. Okay, just a presentation. Okay.
Discussion.
I was just, I think there's some outstanding comments in our letters, but I think they're all technical in nature, and in the past the board has conditioned it that they address the comments and that we do that. The only point I did want to make was that if for some reason there's an issue with the site plan, the subdivision drainage cannot stand on its own. It does need to be, would need to be redesigned to add a recharge component. And I stated that in a letter to the board. So you could even maybe include that as a condition or something, but that would need to be refined.
So under that scenario, you couldn't approve the subdivision standalone?
Well, it you could say addressing a letter from Merrill Associates similar to what was discussed last week.
No, what I'm getting at is if you're saying the drainage from the site plan, from the subdivision plan, all right, you're saying it can't stand alone basically without that other element.
They are, as it stands now, the site plan is providing recharge stormwater to meet the stormwater management policy.
Correct.
The detention basin for the subdivision can't do that, or hasn't been designed to do that. It would have to be redesigned in order to accomplish that somehow.
So we could probably
I think that could be conditioned.
We could consider a minor modification and we could approve the subdivision?
Yeah, I think it could be conditioned is my...
But yeah, you're saying it would be a condition of the subdivision approval that if there was no approval of the site plan for Adams Square, that there would need to be...
There would need to be a redesign of that basin to accomplish the recharge.
To accomplish the recharge.
Or the system.
And just as a point of reference, if we didn't get site plan approval, it would be coming back with a new plan completely anyway.
Anyway, yeah.
So that's that was my only point of writing that letter, just so there's no confusion.
I think it makes sense that there's a variance from Article 3, Section 9, that is something that needs to be addressed, but not by us. I look at, in other ways, it seems to meet the bylaws, and, so subject to some conditions with regard to the variance. And again, the same conditions about the abutter, the screening for the abutter across the street, and addressing the comments in the final peer review. I guess I think that we're in a position tonight to do that. My only question is whether we wait for the variance, but it's sort of like ping pong, right?
I probably want to tell you one thing on this. We thought we would have been done with almost everything over there, but they had conflicts with members, and then the membership is changing. So we would have preferred to have been through there too, but it just didn't happen.
I think we go ahead and approve the subdivision with the conditions and get that off our plate.
There's a
butter.
Oh, I'm
sorry. There's a member of the public.
Hi, Susan Kafka. I actually live on Stage Stop Lane. And getting back to the traffic study, I keep thinking about how the subdivision, being 10 buildings with 2 dwellings each, would be 20 living spaces or individual dwellings, okay? And there is a possibility, first of all, traffic study is not reality, it's a guesstimate. And if there were 2 cars for every one of those, that's 40 cars, not including the freestanding residential homes. Not that everyone would come out of there at the same time, but and I don't think the end of Old Washington Street is that big of an issue right now. The way it curves, it's kind of like a odd turn. But I envision myself going to work and having maybe 6 or 7 cars backed up, and then maybe that would become a problem. I mean, if you've got 40 cars plus the other houses, how many cars are going to be, we can't predict how many cars might be leaving, coming out of there at 7 in the morning or 8 in the morning.
Well, they do use a calculation that is like an industry standard to, based on how many people would be estimated to live there.
Right. But it's not, just my opinion, it's not reality.
No, I understand.
I mean, there's no way to predict
what
everybody's work schedule is going to be.
There was 14 vehicle trips in the morning, entering at 11, exiting in the peak morning hour. That's because some people leave a little earlier and some people will leave later, but that peak hour was 11 cars exiting over the course of an hour.
What is the peak hour, out of curiosity?
It's either 8 to 9 or
7 to 8.
7 to 8. I don't know which one it was.
Keep in mind the condominiums are designed, they're not mandated, but they're designed for over 55. I mean, based on our track record in the area, that is the demographic group that's buying these condos. That's why we're doing first level masters. That's why we're doing very limited stairs, all those things. And the work schedules are not quite the same as, you know, people commuting to Boston and the soccer moms and, you know, all of that who might have, you know, morning trips, picking kids up at school, you know, all of the things that many of us have done potentially for years. But so we do see, you know, that as the demographic group. And, you know, Vinas is considered the foremost authority on traffic studies in New England. You know, they're very accurate. I've actually never seen a study that they've underestimated what it will be. They're usually very good at what they do, and it's also peer reviewed by the town as well.
I can confirm Vanessa's reputation in the field for the neighbor. They are, I guess, the best, if you will. This is no more impact, really, on the local roadway, man, than you say an equivalent subdivision of something like Barker Square, maybe, at the top of route on Barker Street, which is somewhere in the 20-unit range when you come down to what you're referring to. And if you think about Barker Square driveway, in this case, I mean, has it had a big impact on that intersection? Enough to affect traffic and back it up at an hour in the morning?
Now, where is that located? What street?
That's the one that's right next, we'll say, the Sunoco gas station, Barker and 53. There's approximately 10 to 12, there's about probably 14 units, I think, in there of affordable housing mix. So, you know, you have 7 single family homes and the 10 residential, two family, duplex, what have you. It's more senior oriented. I don't see how that could have more of an impact on a more important intersection in town as a practical example to you as to what traffic impact will probably be contained and, you know, brought onto the street of Old Washington Street from this subdivision / residential.
There's also a signal light like that.
Which slows down traffic even all the more.
Right. So...
So you would expect a backup.
Thinking long term, cars being backed up on Old Washington Street, and the way sometimes people are a little crazy on 53, could that long term result in another signal light down there?
I doubt it, because basically you don't see any of the accident experience that you would expect at an intersection that's creating a problem. That is. I didn't see anything in the traffic report that would give emphasis to the idea that we have a problem intersection that has accidents prone to that intersection, that a complication would occur from
some of this. At the end of Old Washington?
Correct. There is no real, do you have real practical knowledge or information for the board with accident information at the site?
No, but my instinct tells me the more traffic you add, then maybe we can increase the chances of accidents.
I guess so.
I guess we can't build anywhere in
Pembroke. I guess so, but we'd be
that's
very...
But that's why we have traffic studies, because we need to either confirm people's instincts or prove them.
And that's everyone's instinct right all the time. But
well, just the way the restaurant is down there, the way they park.
The restaurant is a different story,
right, yeah.
And that's
yeah.
I can't
that's
do anything
your,
about
well,
that. But keep
your,
in mind... Even if this traffic study, which predicted an addition of a 1 second delay at Old Washington, was 5 times wrong, they miscalculated it ridiculous. That would be a 5 second delay. Addition at Old Washington.
The traffic study says there were 2 accidents in a 5-year period.
It's not there.
Additions is another story. And I just drove by there right now, and I mean, there's cars parked everywhere.
Yeah.
It's just. You know, and just the traffic out of dishes would be 10 times the traffic coming out of
right.
this in a meter.
I think the other thing I was hearing a lot from the other residents was the problem is speed, not volume.
Which are both kind of enforcement issues.
They are enforcement issues.
Well, the other point to this, and I know I'm saying it's a hard concept to grasp. I don't mean that in a derogatory way. I mean that because you just don't think of it like that, is when you add a street like this, it's actually a traffic calming mechanism because people become aware someone may be pulling out of there, so they naturally slow down. I come off Washington fast. Oh, wait a minute, there's a street there. I've seen a car pulling out of there a couple of times, and they make, over time, a mental, you know, slowdown. So it's a good thing. Again, it's counterintuitive of what you would normally anticipate, but this street is a calming mechanism.
I think I look at it too, kind of like from the perspective of what is our charge and what is our discretion. And it's difficult when they meet the density requirements of the bylaw and where there's no evidence to rely upon the traffic study that gives, if anything, gives evidence that it's not going to have a significant impact on traffic. I think there's already maybe an enforcement issue on that street and in that on the restaurant that's causing a problem in general in that neighborhood. But I don't think we're in a position where we should tell people they can't develop their land as a result, because we'd essentially be saying you can't develop this land because there might be an impact. I think that puts us in a very
on the other hand,
tenuous position.
Another development could go in there of 100 houses that could have a demonstrable effect on the traffic.
Well, if a full-blown 40B went in there and tried to maximize the number of units per square foot, it would not be subject to our planning rules.
Exactly.
And we would have even less control.
And there wouldn't be a traffic study.
No, you may have 200 or 300 on
it. Well, we wouldn't really have a role.
Right.
In assessing the
wouldn't have any control.
Project.
Stagecoach?
Stage stop. It's almost halfway up Old Washington Street.
Cogliano.
Yeah, where Cogliano's
like
farm
three houses
is.
On
it's not that far.
Okay.
The intersection of Congress. Lastly, how many restaurants have come in and out of that former Bobby Hackett's over
five.
In the last? How many?
Five.
I'm five. Telling you, they all hit the hit parade, don't they? But like all number one hits, they kind of go down the chart somehow. And, you know, you have to really take that into perspective. Everybody in town looks for a great restaurant, but I'll tell you one of the hardest businesses to start and maintain and grow in is a restaurant business in a town like Pembroke. Let me tell you, and you think about the turnover in the restaurant industry, and outside of the popular chains that get up at prime locations where 20,000 car trips are going by them a day on a regular basis, it's hard to sell sandwiches and what you need
Bobby
to
Hackett's
do.
Bobby Hackett's was there for a long time.
No doubt it's a long time spot in the town. It's been around a long time. I won't take that away from it.
But
they come and they go.
But the restaurant really doesn't have anything to do with this subdivision.
No, it doesn't. And I know there's traffic issues at that restaurant, parking issues, I'm sure. I've seen it. Every couple of years with whoever comes in the door.
I mean, arguably the restaurant is not completely unrelated because it's part of us looking at
the
entire neighborhood. But I don't think there's an indication.
That also would have been in the engineer traffic study.
Yeah.
It would have picked that up.
Right. I mean,
conditions.
I think in terms of orienting ourselves, we can't say it's completely irrelevant because
it's part
of looking at.
We're talking about the safety of a subdivision that we're putting on a secondary road system, and is it safe?
Right.
Do they comply? Are they following the rules and regs? So far, they've followed the rules and regs in that it's a safe subdivision, proposed subdivision.
And I don't think there's an indication that it's going to add a lot to what is already there. I mean, if someone was coming up with a proposal to take a corner lot and put another restaurant there, then I think we would be looking at, do you really want two restaurants side by side with all the traffic that that brings at the same times of day, then there would be more of an analysis of the impact of those two together. But I don't think there's any evidence other than it's going to be some additional traffic that would indicate that it's going to appreciably change the mix.
You know, part of the problem with that restaurant is the lack of parking.
Yes.
They don't even have adequate parking for their employees, to be honest with you. And what happens is they come in, and the locals come in, and everybody looks around and says, where am I going to park? And it just becomes a self-defeating problem. And a lot of times, it's a problem we face with small business owners in a lot of areas. They don't know what they need.
Which is parking.
In a lot of cases.
I have a question, though. Sorry to keep going back to this, but the fire people have signed off on this and they're comfortable with the roadway going into the condominium complex.
Did we ever get that?
I'm sorry, forget it.
The chief, exactly what the fire chief.
I talked with him, you know, he's back from vacation yet. I met with him, went over the turning radii, yep. The same at the cul-de-sac, he's at the interior driveway cul-de-sac, and he was fine.
Concerned with the turning angles and stuff like that.
Yeah. So yeah, all of that had been addressed, sure, the radius is on the plan for him.
So could we condition our vote on getting a confirmation of fire chief approval, the variance from the ZBA, and conditions to be written?
There's two different votes, though, isn't there? Two different proposals? Yeah, but we're going to write conditions on that.
So we have to write conditions on the subdivision.
We haven't approved the other one, and that doesn't. We have to wait for that approval.
Should we consider it for approval tonight, subject to obtaining a variance from Article 3, Section 9?
One of the reasons.
We're talking about the site plan.
We would respectfully ask that you're able to do that because we. When we get over there, what they're going to say to us is, well, we really wanted to have the planning board's recommendation, and then we're going to start the bouncing back and forth process. We have no problem with any of the conditions that
we just went through and
talked about.
Well, and we'd also have to make sure that it was clear that if we did any conditional approval, it would also be, you know, on the premise that the ZBA didn't require any modifications, or if the ZBA required modifications.
They would have to come
You'd
back.
You'd have to bounce back to us.
Sure.
And that's absolutely. I think that was anticipated. I think the reason that Bob was asking for it was because we're not quite sure when they would be requested to speak.
Do we have everything for conservation?
Conservation we're filing next. We have done an informal meeting with conservation. The thought was that anything that was going to change, the delta would be with you guys with the site plan process. So that's why we met with conservation, told them the procedure. Normally we do concurrent filings. That really, in this case, if anything's going to change, it's going to be a result of the site plan for the condos, most likely. So we're going into them next, and we're already working on the
system. Instead of kind of playing ping pong back and forth, should we throw the subject to conservation?
So right now I have four conditions.
I don't believe we can legally do that.
No.
Oh, we can't?
No, we can't condition our approval on the board's approval.
We can't?
You could probably put
it on the site plan.
Not on their approval.
We did it recently, I believe.
But on their issuance of a variance.
Yeah.
We can condition, but so what do we do about conservation review? Does it matter?
It's kind of the same thing. Well, they're going to have to go to them independently anyway.
Right, so if anything changes, we're approving a specific site plan. If anything changes on that site plan, they have to come back to us.
Yeah, which they're going to do anyway throughout the process.
Right.
But I believe it's a, which Bob was in here, something legal that we're not allowed to condition our approval on the approval of another board.
Well, don't condition it on approval. Condition it upon, and if there are any changes, you have sort of last right to see it.
We're approving a specific site plan, right?
But can I remind everybody that we recently, with the Dairy Tours project next door,
yeah,
right, And I believe initially with the condos that you folks built on the other site, that because it's stated in the zoning bylaws that the ZBA has the special permit granting authority, that and it's stated in the bylaws that we only review the project in terms of its approval to bylaw.
Right.
But in the end, because they are the special permit granting authority on this site, they have the right to wait our decision. So there is, in fact, precedence here that's just gone on within the past months that occurred because they have the special permit granting authority. They are the end of the road, if you will. And they want us, again, to make this decision at this point in time. Is that correct?
Yeah, and the fact of the matter is really that if we don't receive conservation approval, their approval is a point.
Right, you can't build.
Right, they're a state.
We have to say.
They have state law on this side. That's general law.
So Bob just said what he would be recommending is that you approve it based on if there are any changes, they have to, it has to come back before you.
And I think it's just kind of obvious that if it changes, you have to come back.
Right, but at least it's stated.
We can just approve it, and then you have to go over there anyway.
Right.
And if you don't get a, if you do change, you have to come back anyway.
So what I have down is that we're saying it would be subject to the issuance of a variance by the ZBA.
Could you just clarify that variance and or finding, because they say
yes, and no. Special permit, because they issue a special permit.
Article 3, Section 9. No, I think you need a variance.
Isn't that kind of up to
it's them? A variance special permit. It's happening concurrently before then. Okay, I'm sure you file for the variance, right?
Special permit, though,
and they issue a special permit at the same time. It would be like somebody coming to us at the, where we hold a special permit authority.
But I'm talking about the variance right now.
What about it?
That they have to issue a variance.
Absolutely.
Because I don't want it to go by the wayside that Article 3, Section 9 becomes meaningless. So I do think that it's subject to them issuing a variance.
Well, I think Brian's point was just if it got before the ZBA, who is the variance granting authority, and they say we don't feel this requires a variance, but it's really irrelevant. I think you just put it based on the variance and just there you go. Think what
it is. It also. So what do we do about the fire chief approval? You don't think we can include that?
He may not like the project,
but it still conforms.
And then what do we have on the pier?
He can't deny it based on safety.
Right. Based on safety, but the safety's got to be based on
based
some.
On the ASTRO requirements.
It's got to be based on some facts.
There is requirements. Yeah. You just said that we made them. Done.
We started.
Well,
they usually ask about the hydrants, the locations, the buildings, distance.
You have to have a real unusual situation.
And they're showing them on the plan, so.
And what about?
Factory next door.
Just respond. Acceptable peer review. Reply to peer review comments. I think oftentimes it's been in conditions before.
The fire or the?
No.
The acceptable reply to peer review comments. And that any changes to the site plan would require a return to this board for review. Is that what we're talking about?
Yeah, that was box.
It would be a minor deviation or an amended modifier. They wanted us to change a height location or something.
So I'll move that we approve the, I don't have the number.
SP.
No, it's not approving a site plan, right? We're issuing findings pursuant to the special permit process. Is that right?
I don't know. Do we want to approve this site plan at this point in time? I would assume we do because you're asking for an approval of the site plan, essentially.
But we have to, so we do it separately, I think, site plan, and then, so there's site plan, and then there's additional things we have to do.
Right.
We have to write the conditions of the subdivision.
Subdivision first.
The subdivision was approved at our last session, if I recall.
Well, we're gonna write the conditions.
Correct, but let's take the subdivision approval off the process here tonight, because that was done 2 weeks ago.
No, 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 I'm only talking about the site plan right now.
Then, yes, we have to approve the site.
But we, in addition to our normal site plan review, in this section of the bylaw, we also have to issue findings relative to the special permit that the ZBA relies upon in issuing its special permit. The way this bylaw is written, there's a role for the planning board beyond just site plan review. So does anybody have a copy of the bylaws?
We'll have it just drafted.
No, sure.
Oh, thank you.
Not sure what you know.
Yeah, so, and that was what Bob was referring to at the beginning of the meeting when he went through all the things we have defined.
Yeah, I don't
know. But those are the things typical to
not those aren't the requirements of the special permit.
We don't have any issue on that.
No, we don't. I think what you're trying to do is to say that we're assuming that special permit will be granted based on
our approvals. It's only conditional upon when another board has to approve and determine. It only makes sense in that case. I mean, if there's a role for another board, we can't deny their role. Obviously.
No, so I think what we're looking for is advice.
If they want to go and deny a special permit, that's the prerogative of the ZBA.
No, the question is what we need to give the ZBA.
Right, it's the findings.
To help the ZBA.
Permit, zoning board.
Right.
You're fine
comply
with
the statute.
It's not noisy.
Right.
Yeah, it's not noisy.
The type U's.
They meet all the requirements of the zoning bylaw.
It's in that first paragraph of the site plan approval that the findings are.
The special permit one is
we
easy
haven't
one.
Found anything that doesn't comply. That's what you're asking.
Well,
the very fact
that
we approve it, it says that it.
No, Brian, I'm not saying it doesn't comply. I'm asking what we need to actually include in our motion to comply with this bylaw and give the ZBA the findings it needs based on this quirky bylaw.
If I were making a motion, basically I'd say that site plan X and Y complies with the zoning bylaws and that
conditions is what they need.
Seeking a motion for the board to approve so with any conditions cited or required. Requirements. Simple.
Prove the concept of them entering in and out of that subdivision.
We're basically saying we're fine with this. Okay. Moving on to the ZBA.
I think the findings are basically almost like the conditions of approval.
You
approve it, you vote to approve it, and in the decision it says our findings are this.
You concur?
The findings
well,
basically
you have to
state
specify
what's
the findings
in the second bylaw.
Right.
Confirm
yeah, but
that
it's,
you
like,
say,
it's like the conditions of approval for something.
Basically.
We find this, and this.
We'll have it drafted per each requisite approval. You've done special permit by you guys, special permit by ZBA, variance by ZBA. You categorize each one of them in that handle. Because he knew he was going to have to leave for him.
So I see seven or eight bullet points here listed by Attorney Galvin. He doesn't expect us to read these into our conditions, right?
No.
I think he does.
I think that's what he does.
I mean, the residents are typically empty nesters. What are we talking about?
Oh, no,
here?
No, no. That's what he has, no.
I believe he stated that he was planning on proposing this to the ZBA. He was bringing this to them. That's part of his discussion with them.
Yeah. The first section was the second.
I'm not sure we're supposed to have that.
Those are like the arguing points. Maybe a lot of cheese and then
So are we going to make a motion or write legislation?
Which you've got a motion.
This is what I think he's looking for.
Go for it, Andy. All right, that's so let's make a, so why don't we start with the,
So he does have two conditions of approval, that as a condition of approval, the applicant is willing to work with the abutter on the opposite side to screen lights from exiting traffic if the abutter is willing to allow access.
That shouldn't be included in our,
no.
That's between him and them.
They've already agreed that they're going to work with the abutter.
If we get into that, we're going to be promising people all kinds of things.
You're talking about that for the site plan. That's part of the subdivision.
And as a condition of it, well, it's both. It's the traffic from both that creates the issue.
But a lot of times you'll have roadway that enters into a house.
I know, but we don't want to make private dispensation.
No, but that's not part of the site plan.
Agreements with anybody.
Because they're not as adding any more light than the six houses.
And then he had as a condition of approval, the applicant is willing to accept a condition that further zoning relief, if required, will be obtained to allow access off the new subdivision.
And that's your Article 3, Section 11.
But I think everything else is for the zoning boards.
Pete, you raised the condition, though, that should be added. That was that the
acceptable reply to the peer review comments.
About the fact that if one were approved without the other, for whatever reason, that they'd have to go back to that subdivision plan and make modifications as a result of not being able to. Phase two, if you will.
That's a condition to the subdivision plan conditions.
It's actually to my suggestion would be for both. There are outstanding issues both on the subdivision
and on
the site plan. Technical issues, again, that I believe can be addressed.
Right.
But there are both.
That's a legitimate question. I'm sure they would agree with that. I don't think they're anticipating that the ZBA will shoot them down here, shall we say. So, very unusual for the cookie factory to not bake some cookies.
Although they are, they don't know which members are going to vote. Because they're replacing two members.
I would imagine if Michelle casts the primary vote, they'll go right along with her.
Somebody turn that recorder off.
Yeah. No, I'm not afraid of my comments.
Brian stands by his comments, okay.
All right.
So I guess the answer is that the planning board doesn't seek to impose any additional conditions based on Article 4, Section 2, it's a requirement, special permit requirements. So it would allow us to impose additional conditions, but we don't intend to.
For?
That we don't find that there's...
not unless it doesn't pass its other peer reviews.
Right, but we find that they meet all the requirements to get the special permit from the special permit granting authority.
That's sort of how we...
Right.
That's almost what we're saying.
So they've already...
That we have no objection.
We have no objection to that.
To the granting of the special permit by the ZBA, but that seems like an odd motion.
Oh, really?
Not as odd as this motion sounds already.
Okay, so let's start fresh. You want to make a motion, Andy?
Well, I'll try. I make a motion that we accept the site plan SP3-16 Adams Square with assumption that the special permitting granting authority will do its job and that they will grant a variance based on, Article 3, Section 9 of the bylaws.
And acceptable... to peer review.
An acceptable reply to peer review. Outstanding issues in peer review.
And that any changes to the site plan would require a return to this board for review?
That sounds good to me.
Do we have a second?
I'll second that.
All right. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Aye. Any opposed?
Unanimous?
Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Now we need to write conditions for the subdivision.
We do.
Do we have any follow-up after this tonight? Or can, where do we go?
Senior packets.
What do we have after this, ma'am?
We've got a couple of things I've got.
Is the question estates coming before us?
Yes, he's already here, and I've got RK Centers. I have an extension he can't make it, but this gentleman is here to, for a rebuttal.
Is this equestrian estates business?
Let's finish this. It's going to take somebody else a half, 20 minutes, a half hour to sit here to listen to this.
You're saying, can we take them quickly?
Yeah, can we just take it out of order and come right back to these guys?
Yeah, they thought that these people, he's been sitting here for a long time.
That's what my point is.
We're going to go to the ZBA.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I think we're all on the same page with the conditions.
We'll forward the conditions.
I mean, Bob can write the conditions and send them, and we guys can modify them.
Or you can call Marilyn tomorrow.
We have the conditions in the packet, but we can do that.
Let's get a few other things done.
No, we're just going to take a quick break to take some other matters.
Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Do we need to adjourn and reopen?
I'll make a motion to close the public hearing concerning this is just the site plan or the subdivision too.
Subdivision.
We'll take the subdivision matter up first.
And you don't want to close the public hearing for the site plan?
Site plan, no, but the subdivision plan.
We can actually close the site plan because we voted on it.
Yeah,
we just voted on it.
We just voted on the site plan, so we could actually close both.
Yeah, we could.
Well, probably we could, but aren't we waiving a variance and what have you?
Well, no, but they require additional public hearing.
Okay, so we're assuming that they'll...
Yeah, it's not going to condition additional public hearing.
So, but one at a time. We'll take up the subdivision. I make a motion to close the public hearing regarding Bryson Way extension, I guess?
Right, yes.
Subdivision plan. And the motion is to close the public hearing regarding that.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed?
Well, secondly, I would make the motion to close the Adams Square.
Adams Square, SP 316-16,
public hearing regarding Adams Square, and move that the board do so.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, so we got two public hearings closed.
Okay, because we do have a 90-day extension on Adams Square anyway, so...
All right, we have some time. Yeah.
We have some time, too.
So we just closed the hearing, but we have some time, 90 days. Let's remind our new secretary that that exists.
Agent assistant.
Agent assistant. What about Mr. Equestrian Way? I'm sorry.
No, he's not here right now, but this man's been... It's just a voting slip.
Oh, okay.
And your name?
My name is Chris Grant. I'm with RK Centers.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. North Road, Pembroke North Road Square.
Heard of us.
You've heard of us. You only go by us twice a day, right?
If not, boss. 124
Church?
That's correct.
Oh. He's looking for, you want to explain what you...
Sure. On the building, the 124, which is called the Sleepy's Building, for lack of a better term, where Sleepy's is located.
Yeah.
Right now, there's a sloped asphalt roof. The pitches to the front with aluminum frame, fabric covered awnings for the signs. Mm. We'd like to remove that and do a metal frame ephes facade straight up and then pitch it to the back. Get rid of the shedding of the water to the front. Get rid of the shingles that blow off every storm and the fabric awnings that don't seem to hold up too well. And modernize it. So that's it in a nutshell, really, what we want to do.
How's that
not dissimilar to what we did at North River a couple of years
right,
back.
You want to do it like the
how's closet? That traffic study coming along?
That's what we've
done.
He's asking
extension.
For an extension because he couldn't make it in tonight, so he's coming in a couple of weeks.
Probably with the proposal
to
for
review.
That building.
No, huh?
Probably with the proposal for that building that they're planning on.
In the back?
In the back.
The new site?
Yeah, there's a few things, but he couldn't make it in
tonight.
That's
what he said.
This rowdy slip is just for the roof.
This is just for the 124 church.
So the clerk, I make a motion that the clerk sign the routing slip per the applicant's request.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
So we're signing the routing slip. We're not. There's no review of that. Those changes.
If it's a maintenance item, it doesn't come under like a site plan review because it's just going to say something that's
aesthetic.
Yeah.
Not going to affect
the
drainage or anything.
Essentially, you're saying that it'll improve the drainage slightly.
Hmm?
So.
Well, it did up at the plaza.
Oh, maybe it did.
Yeah. Yeah, it did, actually, if I recall.
Yep. That's exactly what we did.
Just make a copy of that for seconds or less.
No, this is.
So you have to go back to the project stuff. I would only make sure that they have a negative tax for it, actually.
Also,
I think they have drainage in the back.
That's why I would have two.
Plus, they're gonna drag that water down to the treatment plant.
No, because then I wouldn't have it.
I know you're not here for the, I know you're not here for this reason, but you know where the set of lights is there in front of the building you're talking about?
The one, the set of lights down at Lowe's or the set of lights up by the old heater road?
No, the one that's entering into Lowe's.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. You know, why don't you guys fix that little corner thing that the.
Try to take out.
The little brick, brick wall.
I'm not sure that, I believe that's on the state property. Because I know the bottles that develop all the time down there.
You guys constructed the wall, so that tells
you. You guys are holding,
That tells me if the state allows you to construct the wall, you're allowed to maintain it.
I will mention that to the powers to be.
I know it's probably in the state layout, but they must have, somebody built the wall and somebody from the state.
Well, we've only owned the center for, three to four years.
Yeah, right.
That was, but I will certainly mention it too. We're into, as you can tell by the condition it's kept, we're into the maintenance.
Yeah, you guys have been doing a great job up there, so I'm just, you know, again, I know it's not part of your application process.
Thank you very much, everyone.
Just keep it in mind.
Thank you. Arke sent us, like I said, Ken Bryce could not make it in. In your packet is a letter requesting an extension to August 26, 2016.
For the traffic study itself?
Traffic study and the completion of this, you know, the first completion.
Yeah, the phase one, if you will.
Phase one, right.
All right, so I'll make a motion at the applicant's request that the traffic study requested on the site plan, you can fill this in for me, the appropriate site plan number, be extended at the applicant's request of July?
August 26.
August 26, 2016.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye. Okay. We also have the routing slip for Cross Street, which is right here for you guys to start signing. And that is the memory care facility. It's all been approved.
Did you remember?
Yeah, well, I'm gonna be the first one there.
Andy.
There goes your comments.
So what do you need from me?
I want to have the clerk sign the routing slip.
Oh, yeah, I would make a motion that Tom sign, the clerk, sign our routing slip regarding the memory care facility located at 49 Cross Street.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Nay.
There's no, it's all unanimous, right?
We're unanimous on this one.
Okay, and don't forget, we have to sign this. We've got this approval here. Also, while we're waiting, I explained to you guys a couple weeks ago about this bill for the electric bill for the streetlight for Kaleo Park. Thank you. For Kaleo Park. And the bill came to $502.93. Well, as it turned out, it expires our 2 years for the streetlight, paying the streetlight expires on 7/28. No, he's paid the bill. He's paid the bill. So I need I have a copy of the check. The bill's been paid, and I just need the vote to send this upstairs to the selectman's office that now it's time for the, you know, the 2 years are up. So okay. Now we can turn it over.
I move that we turn the street light on Kaleo Way?
Kaleo Path.
Kaleo Path? Over to the town.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Staying on with coming to butter and make decisions on any of this.
What's up? Wait, you don't want to pay the bill either?
It's a fine neighborhood.
Huh?
Yes. Good people.
The bill is for the whole,
really is.
Since he started day one, because he said he never
I'm glad we helped approve that neighborhood.
We got the bill this time.
So anyways, but it hadn't, that 2 years weren't up, and he thought, you know, we should pay the bill, and I said, oh, wait a minute here. So he did pay the bill, and so, yeah, but, you know, so anyways, it's paid. Now we'll just send it upstairs, and that's another street light that'll be not turned off. Also, we also have the, this is the municipal employee status. You guys have to sign. Anybody do the ethics yet?
No, got no ethics.
So is this the special,
this is special municipal study?
Ethically
efficient. Status. And everybody has to sign it.
Actually, I'm watching all the parties, they ain't getting them either, so.
So we will be special.
Yes, everybody has to sign it, so.
Oh, we got it.
Who are you managing, is there anything else?
Well, Peter, you want to stay for the conditions of approval, or?
That's up to the board.
We might need them for the conditions, right?
I think my concerns are in two reports and then that letter. You could just reference those, but it's up to the board. I can stick around if the board wants.
I had a question about equestrian, but.
Oh, he's coming in.
He's coming in.
Has everybody got one of these?
No.
Thank you.
All right, so sign this one. Peter, you referenced these things in the letter you stated. What's the date of that letter, or do we know? You had the letter, correct?
Yes.
July 22nd.
All we really need then is to reference that letter.
Yeah.
Okay, Peter, how would that be, if we reference that letter?
Yeah, I think this, for the subdivision.
Portion.
Portion, it's July 11th.
Yeah.
July 11th, is that?
July 22nd.
July 22nd, that's the.
Site plan?
No, for the subdivision, there's two letters, July 11th and July 22nd.
Okay, so let's make sure.
Yeah, 25th. And then for the site plan, it's July 11th.
And for the site plan, July 11th, so more reference to those letters that we have on file.
Oh, the letters.
Peer review and the conditions that we shared into.
July 11th for the site plan?
For the site plan, and then July 11th and 22nd for the subdivision.
Okay. 7-11, site plan. And 7-22.
And 11.
Subdivision, okay. Okay. Oh, we're moving right along.
So we all set?
Yeah, Peter, I think.
We're all set.
Good night, folks.
Thank you very much.
Peter, you know this is probably the last night you're gonna see Marilyn.
I'll be over.
Request annual reappointment.
Yeah.
Request reappointment?
I will see about.
A reappointment?
Thank you.
I don't know when we're elected, if we're appointed.
So I had tried to find the night when we could all go.
Oh, let's take Marilyn.
There was no night that was good for everyone, and these two haven't been asked yet. But the closest was Wednesday night this week.
Jim can go. Well, we had some minutes voted too, if you guys, I finished.
Yeah, absolution. All good.
Okay, we paid the bills, vote 7-11, 6-27, and 6-7, I sent out to you guys. Did you notice when you got your minutes?
Saturday.
For 6-7, yes.
On Saturday at 3:15 in the afternoon.
I was here all day. Yes.
I did notice, ma'am.
I was at work.
Above and beyond the call of duty.
And, you know, I said to my husband, because he came in to give me lunch, and I said to him, I said, I don't want to hear about it. This is my last Saturday. I turned in my keys Friday. I will not be spending any more Saturdays in here, I promise. Did Ed talk to me? No. Well, that's not it. Ed?
What?
Does Ed talk?
Well, we're in the area about me.
Okay, let me find Mr. Question of States.
Yeah, find it.
So we were talking about.
I think that we need to make a recommendation letter or what have you to the board, board of selectmen, about the possibility of keeping Marilyn on in some capacity beyond July 29. I don't think that we should specify any terms or conditions, but I think that we should give a general approval.
They did say that we can offer her as like a consultant, like, you know, a $25 an hour type thing.
Okay.
You know, Dan went to meet with the Board of Selectmen at the beginning of this meeting to talk about the salary for the person we've offered
I see. What
the position to.
They're just going to carry it on, it's
it was approved, he's
48,000 salary, whatever.
Coming in as a level three in the clerical union.
It's a union position, so it has to come in at so much per hour.
Right. So my only point being, though, they typically want something from this board almost whenever we seek to spend money.
Right, right.
So I'm just wondering if we should kind of act in anticipation, I guess.
Well, I had the discussion with the selectman's office, and I feel comfortable that, you know,
it's, that we're approved.
If I have to go and do it in front of them, I'll go and do it in front of them.
Okay, so you don't think you need
I don't think so. Should we just
pass a motion that we seek approval from the Board of Selectmen to...
I don't think
authorize the chairman to go speak on our behalf.
To authorize the chairman to...
act on behalf of the board to provide for any contractual services?
By Marilyn Zacchello following her retirement.
Hey, we're gonna
excuse me.
You get voted out, you know.
Have you talked to Marilyn about this?
Can I ask you guys about dinner real quick while she's...
Too slow.
So you're not available Wednesday night?
I can't, but I'd have to duck out at like 7:30 or something.
Could we do 5:30? Wednesday night, could you do if we were talking about trying to take Marilyn out to dinner? No, I don't get on until 7:30. Where are you going to be?
Actually, could any other day but Wednesday? He was here. 4 o'clock meeting. So what happened was that these two, Wednesday was the one, you were the only one who couldn't do Wednesday, and every night had at least two or three other ones. We can do those conditions.
Or tell you guys also.
I'd like to try it. I tried it. I was there once before.
What about Orta? Or you like Grove 58?
What
do you want to go to?
I don't care.
Actually, you should care. Where do you want to go?
Where do you want to go?
No,
she
no,
to the top
no,
of
no.
Up. That way
we have the top of the up. We just named all the restaurants in this area. So anyone you pick,
key plans. I signed key plans. Is that on that?
There's more.
Anyone you pick is in the list.
No, no, you guys pick. You guys
no, because it's your dinner.
No, no, no. I will go anyway with Mama B's because I've got that problem with my mouth and I've got to have tomatoes.
Oh, really?
Do you got one, Paul?
I don't eat tomatoes.
Terrible.
So maybe Grove 58 or Dishes.
I'd rather go to Grove 58 unless you want to go to Dishes.
Well, the only question is whether we should stay in town.
Dishes is very, it's very crowded.
So you want to go to Grove 58?
Have you ever been to Grove 58?
Who's that?
I have. Dishes. Nobody goes there anymore.
Have you
oh,
been?
Yeah, I was there Friday night.
Have you been to Grove 58? Who's been to Grove 58?
I have.
And is it good?
Yeah.
It's very good. Seafood. It's primarily I call it seafood.
I think primarily seafood.
Yeah.
Hello, Paul.
We could go at 6:30 and have appetizers without.
Yeah.
Well, it probably wouldn't be a bad idea to show up on the other side of the phone.
Well, what's going on?
I told you that the ambulance is here, the fire trucks are here.
Are we
what happened?
I hope it's not Mr. Question Estates.
No. I'm more worried about the basketball.
No, they're going to the police station.
Maybe it was somebody they pulled in.
Well, it's probably somebody either that or another meeting.
Well,
this
heat is like chest pain.
Yeah.
Well, it could be someone they arrested.
Yeah.
Could
a little
be.
Narcan. Dab it behind each ear.
Well, that could be too.
Where did you find that?
Okay, do you want to start the... that tape recorder is on, right?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Oh, good.
I don't know how it got way down there.
I had to move it to the main office.
I don't want Marilyn mad.
Okay. I like to hear what it's being said.
Right.
All
right, so minutes? Do we have minutes?
Yes. Yes. We started to talk about the minutes, and then we got sidetracked. 7-Eleven.
The store or the minutes?
No, the minutes.
I wasn't at the meeting. I can't do it.
Somebody was.
I wasn't at that meeting.
7-Eleven. I looked at the minutes, so I'll move that. We approve the minutes of 7-11-2016.
Well, maybe I was here on the 11th. I wasn't here last week, is that right?
You weren't here last week.
I was here on the 11th.
Okay, Becky.
I wasn't here at 7-Eleven.
Becky,
no, you weren't here.
Somebody seconded, we said? Aye.
Tom.
Aye,
Tom.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay, the next one is 6-27.
I move that we accept the minutes of June 27th.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Aye. And, of course, 6-7, Paul and Brian don't have them yet because my printer, I could send it out by email.
Sorry, if you can get 4.
Oh, okay.
Right?
6-7, that was the original first meeting of Bryson Way. That was Tuesday 6-7.
Over there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I was there.
Yeah, everybody was there.
Yeah,
everybody was there.
Yeah.
But
so,
Paul and they didn't get their minutes. Because
they didn't get the copy of
the
minutes.
No.
Right. Well, we have 4. Have you read the minutes?
Yeah.
You read the minutes.
Yep.
All right, I'll make a motion that we accept the minutes of June 7th, 2016.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
I'm staying.
Yeah.
Stay.
Yeah, and I'll get the copies in the mail to you.
For present, not voting.
Well, kid, there's a fire in the
Yeah, I told you.
I thought you were just kidding.
You don't believe me? There's an ambulance there now, too.
Is this a question?
Yeah, where is he?
Do you think he went over to the ZBA?
No, because I looked. He should be.
Can we look at the conditions list?
The conditions.
He's not on till 8:15, so he might have gone to get a cup of coffee or whatever.
Sure.
So you want to do conditions for the subdivision?
I'm wondering. Do we want to read through this entire matter, or do we just want to add on to it?
We have the letter, what was it, 722?
Do you want to read through this, or do you want to add to it? I don't mind reading through it.
We had two letters, one was.
Verbatim?
Probably should rotate.
So, do you want me to start reading through it?
You want to go, and I'll pick you up. You want to take half of it?
Actually, number one.
Number one.
I'd like to bring something up. I forget what the last subdivision we did was. But basically, everyone had pretty much moved in, and everyone was using cell phones.
Mr. Questioner States is here.
Okay.
Do you want to?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Okay. Owen is here to talk to the board about you're finishing off your subdivision, right?
Yeah.
And you're going to be presenting, I told you I'm going to need that nursing home quick. Your as-built plan.
We're going to. Right, so the engineers are putting together the as-builts. They're going to be turning them over to Merrill at the end of this month. So probably by the end of the week, the beginning of next. There are only a couple items left, which I've gone over with Peter. One of them is the light pole. When I was talking to Peter about the light pole specifications, he told me to come into the board to talk to you guys about what you'd like to do with that. So there's two in the subdivision. There's one at the top of the road, which is in, and then there's one that's at the intersection between Pheasant, that's spec to be at the intersection between Pheasant and Equestrian. Yeah. Do you guys have a particular style that you'd like to do, and as far as billing and things go, we're talking to Marilyn. I'm talking to Marilyn about the process.
I mean, usually these lights are hooked up to the nearest utility pole. Is there no nearest utility pole?
There's not there, because it's all underground inside the subdivision.
You just want like a specialty light type scenario, is that what I'm...
Well, we have, you know...
Something like maybe 15 to 20 feet high, not quite a utility pole with a big bright light.
So this one here, this corner is pretty small. So yeah. what we had in mind was they have like a 10-foot light pole with a light that puts out, you know, a pretty good amount of light for a street corner, but it won't look like you're coming down.
You know, this will be in the layout. This one becomes ours.
That becomes a problem though.
Right. It'll become ours.
Right.
It'll be DPW's.
Right.
Yeah, which we don't.
So it probably would need to meet whatever specification.
Well, I can see you guys use specification requirement, but he's not going to put in a pole.
Yeah, he is. That's what he's talking about, putting in a pole.
No, I'm talking about a
utility pole.
He's putting in a freestanding pole.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah, I get that.
Just like we have, we require a meter for the...
Right, so there would be a meter. There would be a small panel, and then it would run out to light because... The board doesn't sign off on the acceptance letters until after the road's accepted.
What we have in our rules and regs is we follow whatever the Mass Highway standard is. Same as with a catch basin or a manhole cover or anything else.
What's the gauge? What's involved with that?
Putting a light on a pole?
I'm starting to think. Is underground service to this potentially correct?
There's a chalkboard there.
Didn't at the intersection where you come off of Pheasant and you have a question?
Yep.
Isn't there a pole there?
There's a pole off of Oldham into Pheasant.
Right.
At the first intersection.
It doesn't.
There's no more poles.
They didn't go down to the
intersection? No, it's all underground.
It's all underground.
From
Oldham. So right at the bottom of the hill,
that's what I'm saying. Maybe
the intersection with a question, there's a transformer right there and a handhole. So we pull right from that, and then right on the corner, tucked to the back a little bit, there will be a meter panel. On the meter panel would be a meter, and there would be a small electrical panel.
It's a problem is maintenance of that down the
That's
road.
That's why we need to be a Mass Highway spec, because it's going to be something that doesn't need.
We have to make an exception to the exception rule, which is basically forget the light.
He
Yeah, you forget the light.
We could look at it that way because it's a question running into Pheasant and we have a light at all.
You got a light at the top of the road, which is a requirement of the subdivision.
Which is far more busy a street than...
And then therefore we create a bigger problem than we're trying to solve by adding light to the intersection.
Yep, it's not really an intersection.
Right.
Well, I guess the question is, if Equestria Way, is that an area that could get further developed down the road?
Here's the problem.
I mean, not Equestria Way, I meant the other
Pheasant Lane?
Well,
we can worry about that later.
Yeah, but here's
there is an airport in there.
Right. Yeah. The problem is that we don't allow lighting.
But we'll need different lighting for the airport.
Yeah.
We've got to go on each side of the way.
This is technically...
Because it's not really a whole road.
Basically,
there.
When you think about
it's just
it.
It's the entrance to the cul-de-sac.
Basically,
the five house
equestrian's frontage out to Oldham is actually equestrian.
Right. Don't we actually put in our conditions? Do we say two lights?
Yeah. Both lights are spec'd on the plan.
Are they under our conditions though? What do we? Because usually our conditions we just say wherever it comes out to. Now we could.
Now we'll specify that in the conditions.
If
it's shown on the plan, if it's shown on the plan, I'm sure you.
Yes. Yeah.
If it's shown on the plan, effectively, it's
binding for me, right?
What they're always looking for is the design.
Whatever the board wants.
I don't think we need it.
Okay.
I was just going to say some Brian on that too.
I would just put the one at Oldham and
the one at Oldham is there.
Is there already?
That's good.
I was going to. Yeah, go ahead. So you're going to move to modify the plan?
Yeah, I would just move that we, have the applicant delete from the plan the requirement of the light at Equestrian Way and Pheasant Lane intersection, I guess I'd have to call it.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed?
While you're here, can I ask you a quick question?
Yeah.
Every time I go past the sidewalk as it comes out onto Oldham, it's still kind of a mess.
He's coming to clean it up.
Okay.
Yes, we just moved. We moved the fence, and so we're making some landscaping cleanup there. He'll be doing both at the same time.
Okay.
And he was supposed to happen about 2 weeks ago, so
okay. We're
on top of him for it.
Okay. I just want to make sure that. We're all in agreement that it needs
same thing
to be
for the neighbor on the road there. Yeah, clean, nice, neat.
Yeah.
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 I'm thinking the same thing.
Okay. All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Thanks,
Colin.
There's another major thing that we have. Did you see the nice letter I got from John Schuster,
sure
Molly Macway. I need that vote to reach. We've had that money sitting there for a long time, and every time I've told them that there's money there for them.
Somebody else signed up on it.
So do we actually need to take a formal vote? Is
yes,
that what you're saying?
Yes.
So we all signed the routing slip?
Right. That's right. No, the bill was in the...
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Can I have a vote on that?
So I move that we release the funds held for Donald Chu in the amount of
$3,000.
It was.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, so that's Becky.
Anybody opposed?
Yeah, because I talked to, it's been rolling over in our budget. There's no interest on that performance bond. So basically the $3,000 has been sitting there, and every time I saw him, he'd say, oh yeah, man, well, I'll get you a letter. And that's been done now for a long time. And, you know, so I told Mike that that'll be coming up. So, who seconded that, Andy?
Mm-hmm. Should we note for the record that we're in receipt of Donald Schutz's letter? Praising Marilyn Sakello and her work for the town as planning board secretary.
I thought that was very nice.
Mm-hmm. We join with Mr. Shu in wishing Marilyn a very happy retirement, which we will be celebrating next Wednesday night.
Okay, sure.
Do you want to go with us?
We're all going to be there.
Where do you go?
Where are we going by the way?
We're all going to be in Grill 58 in Halifax.
Oh, yeah, I'll be there.
Okay.
5:30.
What time?
What time did you say?
Should we say 6:30?
6:30, good.
I'm still up.
You can make it 6.
That's
all right. Go at 5:30. I'll
figure
something
out. So you're still on nights. I see what you're saying.
Yeah, you'll just do the first half and you'll do the second half.
So should we start at 6?
Can we do Monday? No.
Monday night.
You're off Monday, right?
I'm off on Monday.
Oh, yeah. Monday night, there's no meeting here.
Can we do Monday night?
Yeah.
Sure.
Monday night?
Yeah, we have no meeting.
No, we have no meeting Monday night.
All right.
So it'd be like a meeting.
Celebrating on Monday night.
Hey, you better post it.
So it's Monday, August 1st.
August 1st.
Do we need to post it?
No, we don't need to post it.
Kind of like, what did the attorney say when
you're going to be out of town?
Sued somebody, it's like adding a pair of suspenders to your belt or whatever, you know what I mean?
I think it's, you know, we just can't.
We should pet.
We can't discuss. You think we should? Should we seriously?
I would.
We want to.
Well, you're gonna have
and a free-ranging dinner discussion.
You have a quorum, so
well, you probably should.
You don't want people to show up.
Well, you know what?
Monday, you can do 6:30.
But you know, put guests welcome.
6:30.
Please don't show up.
5:30.
You can do you really on Monday at 1:30.
You just have to bug out of wherever I'm at.
I know this.
Oh, the ambulance is he backing in here?
What time do you want?
Oh, even on Monday night?
Yeah.
All right, so make it 5:30 on Monday. Okay, all right, 5:30. Can you do 5:30? It's fine. Okay, now, as long as they're serving food, I'll be there. Monday, August 1st at 5:30. Okay, I will ask the powers to be if we just because if we go up to dinner for a retirement party, if we have to post it, I think you do because we're gonna have a quorum.
But you don't, if it's a completely social event, you don't. The question is whether or not you at a social event end up inadvertently talking about town business, in which case you want to give anyone the opportunity to. Anybody can join us who wants to come listen in on our conversation, but they can't. We won't pay for dinner. It won't be taped. Well, that could be. This should not be discussed again. It won't be taped.
Exactly.
I promise.
Okay. Thank you. So what do we need to do on the subdivision?
Basically, go right through this. I'm prepared to go right through this.
All right, just go right through this.
That's where I was.
The last subdivision we did, I forget which one it was, all the residents moved in. They all had cell phones. None of them called for telephone service. And so it was done, complete, as built in. We're doing our final sidewalk, and there's telephone conduit sticking up all over the place.
Where was that?
I'm trying to remember.
South
Path? Possibly, yeah.
Deerfield?
No, I think he's going off of Monroe.
Yes. Yeah.
So how do we deal with that?
That's, we just got to do something. Tell him to put it.
Kelly. That was Kelly.
We need to tell him to put them into handholds or something like that, just so they're not random conduits sticking out of the ground.
We can add that. Terminate all telephone conduit with handholds.
That has to be Kelly or Papa.
They just terminate all utility.
I think that's where
all, that terminate occurred. All utility connections below ground.
Okay. All right, well, see if you can insert that somewhere in here. List of conditions of approval. This is regarding Bryson Way extension. You want me to proceed with this, Mr. Chairman?
Yes, please.
Number one, after endorsement, but prior to the release of any lots, the developer shall obtain written approval of the subdivision plan proposed construction from National Grid. Any changes to the design must be submitted to the planning board. No trees or bushes will be planted around transformers or other underground utility lines. All utility lines
will be terminated below ground.
Terminated below ground.
Do you have that, Marilyn? Add to one.
Yep.
With the following condition, all utility lines will be
terminated
underground. How's that?
Below ground.
Below ground.
Underground, below ground, somewhere.
Two,
The stop sign shall be placed on Old Washington Street at on Bryson Way at the intersection of Old Washington Street. Three, the developer will submit a plan of street plantings prior to the endorsement and will comply with the plan as approved by the board. Four, the developer will arrange a street light to be placed at the intersection of Bryson Way and Old Washington Street at a location satisfactory to the board. Will provide evidence that the cost of lighting has been prepaid for a period of 2 years from the date of completion of the subdivision.
Yeah, but are we going to, excuse me one second, are we going to put, you said Bryson Way and Old Washington Street.
Yeah.
Is it going to go up towards where the condos start? Because you got one, Bryson Way is right there on Old Washington Street now.
Yeah, but they'll just
pick up the light cost in place, that light. If there's a light in place, they just
pick up the cost.
It, that's all. Okay. We're not going to make them put two lights up there.
No. We're not
going to
put a light up.
You're not
going to
put two lights up.
No,
so
and if we want to
make it shine,
so we want to make any changes to the site plan, and we can do that when we write conditions.
I think the condo association or whatever is going to have will have lights within the.
Oh
development.
Yeah, they're going to have their own.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, they're going to have
little
lamps.
Five. Prior to the release of any lots, the developer will execute and record an easement to the town of Pembroke on behalf of itself and the signs, granting the town perpetual access to all easement areas for repair and maintenance, and a covenant to the town not to fill or alter the drainage or other easement areas. Six, note that the developer is responsible for maintenance of roadway according to section 4C5 of the Town of Pembroke Planning Board Rules and Regs. Seven, prior to installing driveway aprons, the developer must contact the Department of Public Works. Eight, the developer will provide drainage calculations reflecting any revisions to the planning board prior to endorsement. Nine,
we have that letter for
I think we can bring the letter. I think we can bring the letter up under 14. Is that what you're referring to, Marilyn?
It's in your packet.
Are these the dates that we spoke about under July 11th and 18th or whatever? These are reference letters. That's what we want to reference. But I don't think it's there.
You don't think this? What's that for letter?
Yeah, you need this one.
Go to 14.
This is. Don't you need this one?
The waiver requests.
You got to put these in.
Well, this is. You've got a drainage calculation. What are any waivers? That's
no,
next.
Nine.
No, yeah, we're not there, though. You stopped me at 8.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah.
No.
No, we stopped you at 9. The letter. Nine.
All right, so you don't have any problem with the drainage calcs, even though Peter references that. Okay. With reference in 9, with reference to the waiver request letter from the applicant dated
July 25th,
2016.
Okay, July
25th,
yeah.
The board.
And then
do we vote on these specific?
No, we have to vote on them.
The board, well then we'd have to stop right here and take votes on 1, 2, and 3.
Okay, let's see.
All right, well, on behalf of the applicant, the Washington ARLs, LLC, one, they're seeking a section of 4C4A dead-end streets. Quote, dead-end streets shall not be longer than 1,000 feet in total cumulative roadway length. Proposed roadway, in the comments, is 1,250 feet of cumulative length. And 910 to the start of the cul-de-sac. This enables compliance with the 150-foot minimum frontage lot requirement and reservation of an accessway to the open space. So they're seeking a waiver of the 1,000-foot dead end, and the total length of the roadway proposed is 1,250. I'll make a motion that we approve that extension of the dead end street.
Good. Given that give this add access way to open space.
Yeah. That shows on the plan already.
Second.
First and second. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Two, the applicant's request under the same section 5. Required improvements for approved subdivision item D, sidewalks. Regulation is quoted as follows. Sidewalks shall be on both sides of the street for major, secondary, and minor streets, and as required by the planning board.
applicant explains that he's seeking a waiver because he wants one sidewalk is proposed on the single-family residence side of the street, another is proposed on the condominium access drive, and a third is provided, proposed to provide pedestrian access to the open space. So I would seek a motion that the applicant be granted a waiver of sidewalks on both sides, and that the side not constructed will be calculated, and that the applicant will provide such estimated costs to the sidewalk fund.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
Third request waiver, plate number 4, typical roadway section. The applicant allow, the language is allow super elevating versus crowned roadway pavement at a conforming 1/4 inch per foot and a relocation of drainage to outside of the paved surface due to less than a 3-foot minimum pipe cover rate. Comment? Allowed sidewalk to be outside of roadway layout is an easement from station 0.0 to station 3.20 in order to maximize the roadway setback from wetlands. Make a motion that
does everyone know what super elevation is?
Jim, I know you explain it to us if you would like, but I have an idea that they're not crowning the road.
It's where you, it's where instead of a road looking like this, it's where you take the entire road and kick it like that to go around a corner.
Sounds like a racetrack.
It's going to drain into the
wetland.
Well, no, remember they were doing it this way to avoid drainage into the wetland.
I think that's where they're putting the water into the wetland.
They're doing it actually to kick all the water to one side rather than pick it up on two sides.
Right.
So, with that explanation as to a super elevating, I would still move that we, the board approve that applicant's request in number 3 and that we waive plate number 4, typical roadway section.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed?
Okay. We have those waiver requests now approved, correct?
Yep.
All right, 10, special construction material and procedures. The owner contractor shall comply with the following special construction procedures. A, the contractor shall provide a detailed sequencing of construction to the board and its engineer at approximately 2-week intervals. B, the contractor is required to notify the planning board's engineer and the planning board by phone or fax 48 hours prior to required inspections and to call immediately should he deviate from the schedule submitted. C, all applicable rules and regulations governing the construction of roadways in the town of Pembroke and Massachusetts, was it highway? Mass highway standards shall apply to construction of this road.
That should say Mass DOT.
Yeah.
Should say other than as other than the waiver provided above. So there's no internal inconsistency.
I think the waiver's we actually have to go back in with this and both the site plan one in my view and review them again and change the language in here. But for tonight we're okay.
Okay.
11. The developer shall provide for water as per the regulations of the Department of Public Works. 12. That the subdivision entitled. Entitled Bryson Way is limited to, what was it, 7 lots?
Yes, there's 2. There's 2 lots on Bryson Way, only 1 house built, and then he's adding 5 additional houses.
And isn't the condo on that?
But that's
the whole condo
the
area.
It's not part of the subdivision.
But it's a lot, isn't it?
It's not part of.
It's not part of the condo, but it's the condo sits on one of the lots in the subdivision. It's a big one.
I would say it's a lot. Yeah. You get access off the roadway to it.
How many house lots were there?
7 house lots.
Can we say 7 house lots in the lot currently designated for Bryson for
and the site plan?
Yeah.
Fine. Yes. That's better.
That the subdivision is limited to 7 house,
seven lots,
house lots plus the lot for the
Adams Square site plan.
Yeah.
All right.
any change in this number requires prior approval of the planning board. 13, accurate as-built plans and profiles of all subsurface utilities, including but not limited to water, gas, sewer, drainage, electric, telephone, cable, TV, showing horizontal and vertical location 2 ± 1 foot. Plans and profiles to be filed in both hard copy and digital format with the planning board and the Department of Public Works. 14, the developer will address and comply with all concerns contained in Merrill Associates letter dated
July 11th.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And July
the second date.
July 22nd. Mm-hmm. July 11th and July 22nd.
All right. And then, Marilyn, you wrote down, what was there another date on the subdivision or just the 11th? The
subdivision has two, 11th and 22, and then the site plan has just 11.
Okay. So basically, we got the two letters dated from Merrill, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'll go with that. 15, correctness of plans. Correctness of plans is the responsibility of the developer. It will include his, successors and assignees. So, 16, except insofar as specifically waived by these conditions, all current planning board rules and regulations shall apply to the subdivision. 17, the approval of the planning board is conditioned upon the construction of ways and installation of municipal services being completed by, we usually grant 2 years. So roughly August 2018, somewhere. August 30th, 2018.
It'll be at least August by the time, because it has to go on an appeal period.
August 31st.
Why don't we even say September 15th or something? Just.
Well, it's usually the date that I stamp the I have the town clerk date, the packet.
So we don't have a date to mention, right?
No, it's got
to
be.
But I would prefer to fill in a date. So I'm going to go with September 15th, 2018.
Okay.
Versus leaving it blank. If construction of ways and installation of municipal services is not completed by the September 15th, 2018 date, approval shall be automatically terminated.
One question. Do we need to specifically say that if the Bryson Way, if the Adams Square project is not approved as designed, that the developer redesigns?
No,
that's part of that letter.
Part of the letter.
It actually isn't, because they'd have to come back to us for a modification of the subdivision plan.
But it's also
not the subdivision plan, though.
It would, because the drainage is part of the subdivision.
Right.
Plan.
So, but I think we specifically call out that they'd have to come back to for a modification of the drainage.
If the other one
went,
denied. But here's the point: doesn't the two letters reference the matter of this matter? That's why I asked Peter directly. Do you mention?
We already say any modification you need, you have to come back to us for approval.
Right, but we need to make clear that the drainage isn't approved unless the other project is approved.
You can add it back.
They can go ahead and
make a motion to include number 18.
They could build the condos with no condos, just the drainage system.
Do you want to wear suspenders?
Yes, I do.
All right. Make it a motion.
But I'm concerned again about conditioning our approval on the approval of another board.
No, we're not. We're just saying that in the event, for any reason, the Adams Square site plan is not approved as currently designed, that they will come back for a review of the drainage plan.
We can add that. I guess we already say that, though.
Yeah. I think so, but I guess you want to add some suspenders to the belt.
Yeah.
I don't have a problem. Is that a form of a motion?
I move that we add that as a condition.
Okay, so basically you want to ensure that, could you just give it one more time for Marilyn's purposes, I guess?
Yeah. In the event the site plan for Adams Square is not ultimately approved according to its current design, that they will return to the planning board for a review of the drainage design for the subdivision.
Okay. I'll second that.
All in favor?
All right, so we're adding an 18, and it's that.
Is there anyone opposed?
No.
Yeah, but I'd rather add,
you want to add it in the middle?
To before 17.
Okay, you want before.
Because 17 is the basic one. All right,
so that will become 17, and we would change 17 to be 18.
Right.
Okay.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Why couldn't you add that to number 8?
Because right. We're done.
Because we're done. Doesn't matter.
Because we're done.
It's the calculation of the drainage.
It is by the drainage, right. Yeah.
Okay, it's done.
It doesn't.
I just say, like I said, it may be overkill, but it's not a problem.
No.
It's not a problem.
You know what else? We've closed the public hearings for Bryce and Way. Now, we need a time certain for the site plan, because they have to come back to us, because we haven't closed that, really, have we?
It is closed.
Yeah, we closed it.
We closed both.
Yeah. We approved the site plan, we have to write conditions at the next.
Okay.
I don't think we should write conditions till we get the zoning approval.
Okay, so we closed both hearings.
And you said we have 90 days from the closing of the public hearing, right, to ultimately make a decision? Is that what you're saying?
Right, we might need another extension. It depends on, see, they're losing their members.
I understand that.
So they might not be able to do it within their time constraints.
Yeah, but they'll get it by default.
Their members can be approved by the selectmen like that.
But no, if they can't make the decision within this allotted time, an applicant gets variance by default.
Right.
Just
one
okay.
Year.
Okay.
I
get it by default?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They can get it by default?
My point, Marilyn, only, when you mentioned 90 days, it's because we closed the public hearing that clock is running tonight?
With the extension that we granted 2 weeks ago, that's running now.
And that's
2 weeks ago, basically
granted an extension.
Extension. He asked because it was expiring like 2 days later.
So would you
so
say
now
we
it's
have,
October 7th.
Would you say we have what, approximately 75 days to await?
Yeah, well,
decision?
October 7th, we have to, do something.
Okay.
So this is my concern. When you leave us, how are we going to know about that October 7th deadline?
Well, it's on the front of the jacket.
Is that what it is? It's on the front of the jacket? Okay.
Everything's up here.
So it'd be like
every time I put it on the computer, I have an expiration date that's sitting right there. I pull it up. That's how I know every month, the 31st bottom one. I know every month what letters have to go out. And it's on the front of the jackets. I try to put all the inside the jacket is the members that attended the first public hearing. I put
terrible predicament that members.
All dates by law are critical. So we have
things
to
drop it
definitely
off.
Keep an eye on this stuff going forward.
They got hacked by the most of
them. I'll
make a motion to adjourn.
We only have to amend it.
A second.
Oh, wait, are we complete, Marilyn? This is your final night.
Is there anything else we need to do?
Last party, do you want to say a small speech?